A repeat robber. A suspect robs a liquor store for the second time, only this time he turns violent. That robber barged into the Palm Coast liquor store off State Road 100 last night, demanding cash and booze.
WESH 2'S Claire Metz reports the clerk ran to a Subway next door, and as the suspect took off, he fired a shot at her.
This window is fixed, but the bullet shattered it, lodging in a wall, thankfully missing everyone inside, including the liquor store clerk who sought refuge here, store employees and customers.
God. Honestly, will of God. She's a good girl. God saved her. Truly think so.
Sharp's discount liquor store manager Carol Urey gives thanks. Her employee and others were spared the wrath of this armed man. There he is at the counter last night, pointing a gun at the 33-year-old clerk. He demanded cash from the register and the safe. He also wanted a bottle of booze. But when he ordered the clerk to give him her phone and go into a back room, she bolted out the front door, and Carol thinks the escape saved her life.
I think, honestly, he was going to put some harm to her. I think that's really why she didn't do it, and thank God she didn't. I think that was his motive, to get rid of her. No witness.
But witness this. He followed the clerk right out, and before taking off, fired at her as she ran into the Subway. This is the bullet hole right over a booth. A very frightened Subway worker called 911.
That door is locked. 911, where's your emergency?
Sheriff's investigators think this same man robbed the liquor store in October. Clearly, the violence is escalating. And the liquor store has been targeted on two other occasions. Management is over it.
Get a job like the rest of us and struggle like the rest of us instead of taking the thug away out and taking money. You know, I just don't have any tolerance.
The victim is so shaken by what happened, she quit the liquor store and a job at another retailer. The suspect stole money, employment, and peace of mind. In Palm Coast, Flagler County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.